honeybees. Today we're doing September empties. I have a bunch for you, so I'm just gonna start right away. So we got the Kirkland baby wipes. I get these at Costco. They're really great because they're very saturated and they're a larger cloth. I use them every morning getting ready because I'll get makeup on my hands and I'll just wipe it off with this. I even clean off my makeup counter with these. They're really inexpensive and awesome. And then I used up some Epsom salts. This was in the lavender scent. These are from Walgreens. I use Epsom salt to soak in my bath when I've had like a really hard exercise day. Like if you're doing a really intense workout and you know you're going to be sore the next day, Epsom salt works so great. Or if you had a deep tissue massage and they worked you a little too much and you're feeling the pain, Epsom salt is your baby. I have to go and repurchase some of that. I used up two foaming hand soaps from Bath & Body Works. The first one is Mango Paradise. This is in the old packaging. This is what the packaging looks like now. This smelled really, really tropical and definitely has a mango scent. Oh, it's so fruity and delicious. So I had that one in my bedroom, and then this one was used up in the bathroom, the guest bathroom. Toasted Vanilla Coconut, another one from the summer. Oh my gosh, I loved this scent. It's so sweet and it's just so delicious. And I love the gold detail on the top too, instead of the, whoop, dropping things, instead of the white. So yeah, I used up two this month. I also used up the Vaseline Intensive Care Spray Moisturizer with Aloe Soothe. This actually lasted me quite a long time. I feel like it was hydrating. It absorbed very quickly into the skin, but it's a light moisturizer. If you are super dry, I don't feel like this is going to be good for winter. It is non-greasy though, and it did feel really nice. And I didn't have an issue with the spray. Like, I had a continuous spray with it. So yeah, overall I did enjoy it. I don't think I'll repurchase it anytime soon though, just because I have other moisturizers I need to use up. I used up some Shiseido Facial Cotton. This stuff is amazing. It is the softest cotton you will ever use. It doesn't break apart when you put your toner or eye makeup remover on it, and it's so gentle. I absolutely love this and will definitely repurchase it when the friends and family sale comes very shortly here. I used up some Nature's Bounty Hair, Skin, and Nails. This is the extra strength version. 5,000 mcg of biotin. Also has ACE plus hyaluronic acid. So there were 250 capsules in this. It obviously took me a while to use. I used three a day. The serving is three soft gels. So I haven't seen a huge difference in my hair and nails, but I do feel like this vitamin, as well as the other things I'm doing to help my hair, has been improving the quality of it. So I am going to continue to take this. I have a whole nother bottle of it, and we'll see. We'll see if the results continue. I also used up this 3.3 fluid ounce of the Rehab Shampoo from Lush. This is more of like a clarifying, really deep cleanse shampoo, and it did work well. It has a very lemony, I can't explain it. It's like one of those spa kind of scents. I didn't especially appreciate the scent, but the shampoo itself was nice. It is pretty pricey though, so I don't think I would repurchase anytime soon. I also used up a Murad Hydrating Toner from the Resurgence line. This is a sample size, had 0.5 fluid ounces. It actually lasted quite a long time though, and it smelled really great. Yum, it just smells really good. It's like a very fresh floral scent. So I really love Murad products. I would definitely purchase that. I also used up another Wallflower. This one I believe was one of the pumpkin scents. No, it's like it's watermelon lemonade. So another one of the summer scents. Then I used up a Poopery. If you've never heard of Poopery, you spray this in your toilet. It creates like a film on the top of your water, so then when you go number two, it doesn't smell, or it doesn't smell as bad, I should say. I swear by this. I've gotten so many people to buy this and they swear by it now. This was the bigger size. 4 fluid ounces, and it was the Secret Santa scent. Honestly, all of the scents have a lemon undertone, so it really doesn't matter what scent you get because they're not going to be very different. This had like a slight kind of cinnamony Christmas scent to it, but really it smells like lemon for the most part. The only problem I have with Poopery though is their spray nozzle ends up getting clogged halfway through the bottle every single time, so I end up having to pour it out And that's really annoying and wasteful because I feel like I end up using more without the spray bottle. I mean, yes, I could repurchase a different spray bottle and use it, but I wasn't about to do that. So yeah, that's my only complaint. I also used up a sample of this amazing, from Perfectly Posh. I got a sample of this from a great subscriber of mine. So the line is Perfectly Posh, and this is the Big Fat Yummy Hand Cream in Amazing Fresh Mint and Wild Honey. I liked the formulation, but I didn't really like the scent of this so much. And like I said, I have a bunch of creams to use up, lotions to use up, so I won't purchase that anytime soon. I also used up a rose eye mask from Sephora. I really, really like these. I do feel like my under eye looks refreshed after using one of these. Yeah, it's pretty much a one-time use though. You could try to get two uses out of it, but I have only got one use. I used up, I'm only showing you this like loofah from Bath & Body Works because I think these are the best quality I found. Now, some people might disagree that they feel like you can get, you know, it anywhere, but this one's extra fluffy. I really feel like my bath products foam up a lot with this one, and I don't know why this one over others, but I would definitely repurchase the one from Bath & Body Works. I also used up a fragrance sample. This is the DKNY Be Desired fragrance. Now, this is kind of along the same lines as Be Delicious, but it has a little bit more of like a florally tone to it, something more mature about it. I still like Be Delicious way better, but that was nice. Okay, I used up a bunch of makeup products, so I want to share that next. Used up a beauty blender. This is the Black Beauty Blender. These last me for about, I'd say about 4 months. And then this one's has started breaking on the top. It's absorbing too much of my foundation because the pores in the sponge itself are too large. So I'm going to be throwing that away, but I have plenty of backups. I love my beauty blenders. I also used up a Gimme Brow from Benefit. This is holy grail status for me. I know I haven't done the ride or die tag yet, but if I am ever gonna film that, this would definitely be in it. It has a very small brush to brush fibers. It's like a fiber with color, and brush it into your brows, and it gives some fullness and definition to the brows. Yes, I have tried the Essence version of this. It's not the same. It's cheaper by a mile, but it's not the same. I still like Gimme Brow way better. I've tried so many different brow, like mascara, fiber kind of products, and Gimme Brow is the best, in my opinion. I also used up a Nuance, this is Salma Hayek's line of makeup, a Precision Eye Marker. This was nice. I felt like it lasted really well. Nice, deep, dark color. I just didn't like that it was a marker, like felt tip marker, because it did start to dry out very quickly, and I would really have to like shake it and push the product, and like I would push this little top part into my hand so that the liquid would come down to the tip. I don't know, I just like brush tip applicators way better because I feel like they distribute the color better. But this was a nice product, and it's drugstore. I also used up a blush, which I'm really pumped about. This is the e.l.f. blush in the color Tickled Pink. I've been trying to use this up for a while now. Every little bit is out. I will insert a clip here of me swatching the color for you before it ran out. It was a very pretty color. There's only 0.097 ounces in this, so that explains why I always use up my e.l.f. blushes faster than any other blush. And I think the color was very pretty. I would consider using another e.l.f. blush. I have so many blushes though that I definitely cannot allow myself to buy another one anytime soon, but I'm excited to have used one up. This one, sadly, was not used up, but it is drying out and I'm not able to get any color pigment off of this. It is the ColourPop blush in Trickery. It's a beautiful shade, but unfortunately it just doesn't work anymore. So I am going to have to toss that out. And last but not least, I consider this a makeup product, but really it's skincare and makeup. The Eye Duty Triple Remedy from First Aid Beauty. This is probably the second or third one I've used up of this. As you can see, I did cut it open and scrape every little bit out. It's completely empty. I'm not sure you can see that on camera. But this, and it also has like a little squeeze top, metal tip so you can rub it in easily. It's an eye cream that has a salmon coloring to it, so it really cancels out discoloration under the eyes. It's very hydrating, it depuffs, it's supposed to brighten. So this is definitely, again, holy grail status for me when it comes to my eye cream in the morning. This is my go-to. A lot of times I'll use this when I don't want to put makeup on, but I just need to cancel out some darkness under my eyes, this helps tremendously. So I will need to repurchase that again at the Friends and Family sale coming up with Sephora. I believe it's going to be mid-October that sale happens, so make sure to get your lists ready. And, oh, I almost forgot to share my candle and my food empties. Okay. So this is the pumpkin cheesecake candle from Target. I heard that this is now nowhere to be found at Target. I wonder if they discontinue this. I know a lot of people will be sad. This is a soy candle, so it burned really, really well. It's a two-wick candle. It smells really good. I love the rose gold lid. I actually don't think I'm going to depot this, though, because I have so many, like, depotted candles around my house. I really don't need any more, but this is a beautiful, beautiful lid. And this had, like, a... Dude, they don't have a description on here. I don't really smell pumpkin cheesecake. It's sweet, like a bakery scent, like a pumpkin-y bakery scent, but it's not as, like, tart as a cheesecake scent would be. It's really, really yummy, though. I did enjoy it while it lasted. Had a great throw, great burn time, but I don't know if I would repurchase that specific scent, but I guess you can't even anymore. Anyways, I'm pretty sure I've already spoken about this so many times, but Boom Chicka Pop S'mores, if you have not tried this yet, you are missing out tremendously. I've seen it at Target, and I've seen it at Walmart, I believe. Was it Walmart? I know for sure it's at Target. That's all I gotta say. I'm still on the mad hunt for the pumpkin spice one. Everyone keeps telling me that there's a pumpkin spice one. I can't find it to save my life, but I'm still on the mad hunt for it. Okay, these are also found at Target. They're the Archer Farms pumpkin spice pretzels. Holy moly, you guys. First of all, I'm a big fan of sweet salty together. So I really love, like, coated pretzels, but these taste like you poured a pumpkin latte over pretzels. Like, the taste of the coating tastes like a pumpkin spice latte, and then you have the pretzel underneath. These are dangerous. I'm warning you right now. Both of these things are dangerous. I probably won't repurchase these just because that's how dangerous they are. Like, literally, I can eat this bag in two sittings. It's horrible, and they're supposed to be 5 servings in this bag. So they're really, really dangerous, but they're very, very yummy. And if you have self-control, I would suggest them. So that's it for my September empties, products I've used up. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing this. If you're new, please subscribe and like this video if you want more empties continuously. This is pretty much the video I am so consistent with. Every single month I have an empties because it's my favorite to watch and favorite to film. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you again real soon. Bye.